I have three answers that I've shared with you. When are we going to use this in real life? I have a fourth answer. Mathematics is the most creative of the arts. You don't study Shakespeare because you're going to use it. You don't go to the movies on Friday night because you're going to use it. You know, you don't look at this beautiful tree because you're going to use it. Hopefully. I hope we don't use that tree, right? I hope we don't turn it into paper. There's a time and a place to use things, and that's great, and that's fine. Mathematics can help us with that. But the beauty of becoming lost in patterns and what must be true given certain things is a feeling that we can get from nothing else. But I hope, at least every once in a while, I help you glimpse just a little bit of real mathematics where the point is to wonder and try to discover something that must be true. You know what I mean? Pythagorean theorem was discovered independently many times around the world, which is a pretty astounding thing if you think about it, right? And it's on this Voyager because it, in theory, very well could be discovered anywhere in the universe. And that is something that no other subject can say. Maybe some of the sciences, maybe. But math is so basic and fundamental and yet abstract that beauty is what I'm hoping to help you see. One of the beautiful things about mathematics is that you can just be thinking, writing to reflect that thinking.
One part is longer, but I feel like this is kind of another type of beauty.
And then there's this, bam, wait a minute, what? I see a student laugh when there was no joke. I see a student just react to something, but it's all something in their head. They're getting that aha moment, and that only happens when they didn't see something before. It's always pleasant to be right, but it's generally a much more useful thing to be wrong. And so a lot of times, a really good mistake is much more valuable in my class than just the right answer. If there's a good mistake, that implies that there's some value, some interesting pattern, something that this student noticed. We all get to evaluate that and figure out what's going on. How did this student make this mistake? Or a lot of times I put mistakes on the board or whatever.
You're saying that my division is an issue? Right. Don't tell my fifth grade teacher. 64, is it?
Most students, and adults for this matter, think that mathematics is the subject that requires the most memorization. That you go in, you memorize this algorithm, this is what you do, this, then this, then this, follow those directions, okay, here's my product. I don't really know what I did because I just followed the directions, but it's that. Yes or no? Is this right? Whereas real mathematics is, okay, I don't know what the question is. Like, what do I notice about something? Okay, is there something to explore? Oh, is there a connection? Oh, wait, no, there's this other thing. But if that's true, then what does that mean?
If you didn't space the nails evenly,
mm-hmm,
and, like, had a nail, and then a centimeter, and then a nail, and then 2 centimeters, and then a nail, and then, like, 3 centimeters or 4 centimeters.
Where it would increase in a linear fashion?
Yeah, or maybe a exponential fashion.
Okay.
Then you would get a parabola.
Oh, would you?
So the SAT, the AP test, these aren't real mathematics. What mathematicians are actually doing when they're breaking new ground, nobody has a stopwatch next to them as they're thinking about these things. How do I balance that with what I'm required to do? I teach algebra, I teach geometry, I teach pre-calculus, whatever it is that I'm teaching, there's a set curriculum. And my students are expected, their parents are expected, the college that they're applying to is expected, that they learned a certain amount of material. The balance has to be me trying to push them, lead them towards hopefully the discovery of some of that material themselves, rather than me just saying, here's the way it is. And yet we still have to get through a certain amount of curriculum. That is tough because obviously the discovery takes time, but if I can help students uncover some of the ideas themselves, then obviously it sticks with them more. I really hate having students memorizing formulas. I want students to be able to figure out the formula themselves on the test.
hopefully, what I want them to be able to do in 5 or 10 or 20 years is to be able to remember that they have the ability to look at something abstract or make something abstract and model it and then think through the patterns and the possibilities of what may or may not be true. And to just look around and notice things that they didn't notice before and wonder about the relationships between things that they never saw before.